In October of 2010, CFIUS, the Committee on Foreign Investments in the United States, a cabinet-level body that included Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, met to consider and then to approve the sale of a company to Russia that controlled one-fifth of the uranium supplies in the United States. But unknown to the CFIUS board or to the public, 2 years before, in 2009, the FBI found out about a Russian spy plot to infiltrate the United States with spies, with the goal of influencing contractors, people, donors, politicians, and ultimately Hillary, to approve that sale to Russia. That was one of two things that they did to try to do that. The other, of course, was that Bill Clinton received a $500,000 speaking fee from Putin during a trip to Moscow a few months before the CFIUS board met to approve the sale. But that 2009 exposure of these spies remains secret in the FBI, and rather than round them up and publicize it, it continued the investigation and kept it quiet, even though it was clear that they had an indictable offense back in 2010. They did not want to roil the waters and make Hillary's vote in favor of the uranium sale politically problematic. It wasn't until 2014, when the statute of limitations loomed and they were about to lose these spies, that they actually moved to indict and convict them. And the chief spy, a guy named Vadim Mikurin, was not indicted for money laundering or for espionage or extortion or any of the counts they had, but rather for a very low count, which was making an agreement to commit a crime against the United States, carried a prison term of up to 5 years. He himself got 4 years. And the whole goal was to keep this under the radar. There was no perp walk, there was no FBI press conference boasting about how they smashed this ring of spies. There were no great bells and whistles. To the contrary, it was all kept on the QT. And the prosecutors on this deal were two guys who are now central to the Mueller probe of Trump. One is Rod Rosenstein, who is now the Deputy Attorney General, who is the guy who appointed Mueller in the first place. And the other is Andrew Weissman, who is really the chief prosecutor on Mueller's staff as special prosecutor. So these three guys, who were Hillary cronies, got together and deep-sixed hid the whole evidence of this Russian spy plot. When Peter Schweizer wrote his book Clinton Cash in 2015, that exposed the juxtaposition of the decision of the CFIUS board to sell the uranium and Putin paying Bill Clinton $500,000 in cash for giving a speech in Moscow a few months before. He didn't include this because nobody knew this. It was kept hush-hush and continued to be so until it came out in the last few weeks. This is evidence of complicity and secrecy in hiding the real collusion, which was between Putin and Russia on the one hand and Hillary Clinton and the FBI on the other. Thanks for watching.